Our opening hymn is number 37 in your missalettes, Holy, Holy, Holy. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early in the morning our song shall rise to thee. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity. Holy, 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 all the saints adore thee, casting down their golden crowns around the glassy sea. Cherubim and seraphim falling down before thee, with ever and ever evermore shall be. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather to celebrate the Eucharist today, we pause and we ask Jesus to forgive us our sins.
Lord Jesus, you rose gloriously from the dead, giving us hope of eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you ascended in glory to your Father's right hand, and now intercede in our behalf. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you fulfilled your promise and sent the Holy Spirit upon us to lead us and guide us on our way to the Father in heaven. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, whose abundant grace prepared St. Henry to be raised by you in a wonderful way for the cares of earthly rule to heavenly realms, grant, we pray, through his intercession, that amidst the uncertainties of this world, we may hasten towards you with minds made pure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Hear the word of the Lord, princes of Sodom. Listen to the instruction of our God, people of Gomorrah. What care I for the number of your sacrifices, says the Lord? I have had enough of whole burnt rams and fat of fatlings. In the blood of calves, lambs, and goats, I find no pleasure. When you come in to visit me, who asks these things of you? Trample my courts no more. Bring no more worthless offerings. Your incense is loathsome to me. New moon and Sabbath, calling of assemblies, octaves with wickedness, these I cannot bear. Your new moons and festivals I detest. They weigh me down. I tire of the load. When you spread out your hands, I close my eyes to you. Though you pray the more, I will not listen. Your hands are full of blood. Wash yourselves clean. Put away your misdeeds from before my eyes. Cease doing evil. Learn to do good. Make justice your aim. Redress the wronged. Hear the orphan's plea. Defend the widow. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response is, to the upright I will show the saving power of God. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always. I take from your house no bullock, no goats out of your fold. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Why do you recite my statutes and profess my covenant with your mouth, though you hate discipline and cast my words behind you? To the upright I will show the saving power of God. When you do these things, shall I be deaf to it? Or do you think, you, that I am like yourself? I will correct you by drawing them up before your eyes. He that offers praise as a sacrifice glorifies me, and to him that goes the right way, I will show the salvation of God. To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
May the Lord be in your heart and on your lips, that you may worthily and fittingly proclaim his holy gospel in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
According to your honor.
Jesus said to his apostles, "Do not think that I have come to bring peace upon the earth. I have come to bring not peace, but the sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And one's enemies will be those of his household. Whoever loves a father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is righteous will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink, because he is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely lose his reward." When Jesus finished giving these commands to his 12 disciples, he went away from the place to teach and to preach in their towns. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In the first reading for the last couple months, we've been hearing a lot about the history of the Israelites from the time of Solomon down to the time of the Babylonian captivity and so on. And now for a while, we're hearing about the prophets during these times. Prophets were unique in Israel. They were people with a very keen sense of conscience and very much aware of what God wanted rather than what everybody else was doing. And so very often they spoke out, and as I mentioned some time ago, they spoke out in four main areas. First of all, they called people back to be sincere in their worship and the practice of the faith, and not just go through the motions. Secondly, they reminded people, especially the wealthy, that they have a responsibility to pay wages and look after the poor and assist them. Thirdly, they were very much involved in politics of the time, trying to encourage the people not to make alliances with other nations, because once you do that, sooner or later you're going to line up with the wrong side and it'll lead to destruction. Unfortunately, the kings and the people didn't listen to such warnings, and so when they were conquered by the Babylonians and then other people's rules like the Persians, later on the Greeks, the prophets preached a message of hope. God promised David that from his descendants would come a line of kings that would establish a kingdom that would last forever, and God will keep his promise no matter how badly things seem to be going. And each prophet had a different focus in mind. Amos was one who proclaimed justice, and he condemned the rich for taking advantage of the poor and treating them unjustly. Hosea, as we saw in the last week, because of his sad experience with his wife's infidelity, came to realize that the people of Israel were unfaithful to God and always turning to worship the idols of the day. And one thing we have to understand is that in those days, people believed somehow or other that the gods were territorial. And really, we can understand it, we who are Cornhusker friends, for many, many, many years. When you move to Nebraska, you better become a Cornhusker fan. And our idols were Tom Osborne and people like that. Now, if you move to Oklahoma, then you had to worship Barry Switzer and become a Sooner fan, and so on. So people believed the gods were kind of territorial, so very often they fell into the practice of worshiping gods of the territory. And so the prophets condemned that. Isaiah stresses the holiness of God. And we'll hear that again and again, but also the justice of God too. And because Isaiah is so aware of God's holiness, he really pounces upon people who just go through the motions of worship. The Sunday morning Catholic comes because it's a duty to do so. They hope it'll be short, get over as quickly as possible, and then go home and for the rest of the week forget about God. So Isaiah especially spoke out against things like that, and that's his message today. And he says very clearly, God doesn't want you bringing your sacrifices to the altar unless your heart is sincere. And if your heart is sincere, you'll not only bring your gift to the altar, but then you'll go out and do something about it the rest of the day. And that's what we're all called to do every time we come to celebrate the liturgy of the Eucharist. We celebrate God's presence, Jesus becoming present under the form of bread and wine. We receive him, and then the deacon announces that the Mass is ended. And it isn't a saying, okay, it's over now, go home and forget about God. But no, you've heard God's word in the readings of Scripture. You've been strengthened by Christ's presence in the Eucharist. Now go out and put into practice what you have learned, strengthened by Christ's presence. So that's what Isaiah is calling us to do. And we'll hear more from Isaiah again in the weeks ahead. And every Mass, we quote his words when we sing the Sanctus, the Holy, 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 Lord God of Hosts. Comes directly out of Isaiah, his vision of the grandeur and the splendor of God when he was first called to be a prophet. Today, as we reflect on these scriptures, we ask Jesus to help us to keep them in mind and put into action in our daily lives the faith that we profess here at Mass. O God, our Heavenly Father, as we gather here this morning to celebrate the Eucharist, help us always to be aware of your presence and the presence of your Son, Jesus, under the form of bread and wine. Strengthened by his presence, may we go out and proclaim your love to others by what we say and do. Grant us this, Lord, and the favors we now ask in Jesus' name.
Pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for Archbishop Lucas, Bishop Hanifeld, and Bishop Conley. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those who serve us in public office, that especially in this time of crisis, they will strive to work together for what is best for our country. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, the building blocks of society, that each member will show love and respect, patience and willingness to work together. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for all who are ill that they will experience God's healing power. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our departed loved ones, especially for Dwight, Duncan, Geraldine Seaman, Father Val Peter, and Father Jim Swartley, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all policemen, highway patrolmen, law enforcement officers, and firemen, that they may be kept safe from harm, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor and homeless, for all races living in the slums of many of our cities who have every reason to be angry with politicians, who remember them only before elections, but do little to help them better their conditions once elected, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of our unspoken needs and intentions, let us pause and pray to the Lord in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We offer this Mass this morning for the living and deceased of the August and Marie Boger family. We pray to the Lord. O God, our Father in heaven, please grant us these and all our needs, for which we pray to you today in Jesus' name, for he is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer with humble and contrite hearts. Wash me, Lord, of my iniquity. Cleanse me of my sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the salvation, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look upon the offerings of your church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring even greater holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished that marvelous deed by which he freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of now being called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and blameless sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your Holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard and govern and unite her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all who are gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or the offered for themselves and for all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, and the hope of health and well-being, and paying homage to you, their eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of God and our Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter, Paul, and Andrew, and all the saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. And therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service and that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and count them on the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, as Almighty Father, giving you thanks and praise, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. And therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection to the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kind countenance, and to accept them as you once were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hand of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, and may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who those sinners who hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in the fellowship of your apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Saint Isidore, Saint Henry, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord. Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and make them holy. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit. Share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us your peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Blood of Christ.
Amen.
Our communion hymn is number 438, Only a Shadow. The love we have for you, O Lord, is only a shadow of your love for us. Only a shadow of your love for us, your deep abiding love. The bread we take and eat, O Lord, is your broken and shared for us. Your body broken and shared for us, the gift of your great love. Our lives are in your hands. Our lives are in your hands. Our love for you will grow, O Lord. Your light in us will shine. Please join me in making a spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desired to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and grant you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace to glorify the Lord by your works.
Thanks be to God. Our final hymn is number 594. For the fruits of the earth.
For the beauty of the earth, for the glory of the skies, for the love which from our birth over and around us lies. Lord of all, to you we raise this our hymn of grateful praise. For the beauty of each hour, of the day and of the night, hill and veil and tree and flower, sun and moon and stars of night. Lord of all, to you we praise this our hymn of grateful praise. For the joy of human love, brother, sister, parent, child, friends on earth and friends above, for all gentle thoughts and mild. Lord of all, to you we raise this our hymn of grateful praise.